Hello Vavers, you're watching YouTube channel Daily USA News Alert. Breaking. Ilhan Omar called Obama murderer, will Democrats still defend her? A new report says freshman Representative Ilhan Omar doesn't want everyone to feel comfortable around her. She's making good on that claim. After what she said about Obama, I'm not sure he'd feel comfortable around her. Fox News reported that Omar, fresh off igniting an intra-party uproar with comments widely viewed as anti-Semitic, took a swipe at former President Barack Obama, saying in an explosive interview the 44th president's message of hope and change was a mirage and blasting his administration's drone and border detention policies. Omar, D. Minnesota, took aim at the president's famed slogan, while further criticizing the Democratic Party for perpetuating the status quo, in the interview with Politico. Recalling the caging of kids at the U.S.-Mexico border and the droning of countries around the world on Obama's watch, Omar charged that Obama operated within the same fundamentally broken framework as his Republican successor, the piece reads. She also called Obama a murderer. Per Yahoo, Omar said we can't be only upset with Trump, Omar told Politico for a profile that was published Friday. His policies are bad, but many of the people who came before him also had really bad policies. They just were more polished than he was. That's not what we should be looking for anymore, she continued. We don't want anybody to get away with murder because they are polished. We want to recognize the actual policies that are behind the pretty face and the smile. Omar, a Muslim and a Somali refugee who wears Islamic dress in public, noted the caging of kids at the U.S.-Mexico border and the droning of countries around the world, for which Trump has been criticized, happened on Obama's watch too. Obama's office did not immediately return a request for comment. A new report on the Democrat Party's identity crisis signals Representative Ilhan Omar, DMD, intends to continue being a lightning rod for controversy despite bipartisan blowback over her repeated trafficking in anti-Jewish tropes. Politico magazine's chief political correspondent Tim Alberta interviewed Omar and Representative Dean Phillips, DMN, in recent weeks for an article detailing how the Minnesota Democrats' dueling visions for the future indicate more turmoil to come. Alberta writes, to better understand these dueling visions for the Democratic Party, I sat down with both Omar and Phillips, spent several days in their communities and talked with some of their constituents. What I learned is that, despite the cautionary tale offered by years of vicious Republican infighting, Democrats are dangerously close to entering into their own fratricidal conflict. On matters of both style and substance, the fractures within this freshman class are indicative of the broader divisions in a party long overdue for an ideological reckoning. And Omar isn't shying away from it. I am certainly not looking to be comfortable, and I don't want everyone necessarily to feel comfortable around me, she told me, a mischievous smile tugging at her lips. I think really the most exciting things happen when people are extremely uncomfortable. Phillips, a friendly soul and consensus builder by nature, is among those feeling a bit uncomfortable. Amid a discussion of Omar and Ocasio-Cortez, he complained, suddenly an entire party is being branded by the perspectives of two of its members who represent 1% of the caucus. The profile's release comes after the House passed a resolution Thursday condemning anti-Semitism and other bigotry. Democrats are trying to push past a dispute that has overwhelmed their agenda and exposed fault lines that could shadow them through next year's elections. The 407-23 vote Thursday belied the emotional infighting over how to respond to Omar's recent comments suggesting House supporters of Israel have dual allegiances. For days, Democrats wrestled with whether or how to punish the Minnesota Democratic lawmaker, arguing over whether Omar, one of two Muslim women in Congress, should be singled out, what other types of bias should be decried in the text, and whether the party would tolerate dissenting views on Israel. Republicans generally joined in the favorable vote, though nearly two dozen opposed the measure. Representative Lee Zeldin, RNY, himself a Jew, called it a sham.